Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. The core focus of a forensic toxicology laboratory is to determine the presence or absence of drugs in biological samples. Oftentimes, when it comes to drug testing, the sensitivity of the method is critical because it can be small amounts that you need to detect. So let's hyperspeed through toxicology analysis and look at liquid samples such as urine, blood, and saliva and see just what we can uncover and learn from the past to the future.
Great Scott! She's back!
I got that.
That's right, I'm back from the future, and it looks like I have the power of two to help me solve my complex questions today.
Jennifer, allow me to introduce you to Professor Botchstone. She's a professor of toxicology at Boston University School of Medicine. Last episode, we talked about how multidimensional has a difficulty to understand or to learn. Here you have a user and a believer of the technology.
So, Sabra, how do you use multidimensional chromatography to solve your problems?
So, we've been partnering with Claude and Waters to utilize multidimensional liquid chromatography for the analysis of biological samples.
So what are you working on there?
So this is a urine sample. It's probably one of the less complex samples that we deal with. But the point is that we have to extract out any drugs or other toxins from the urine sample to determine if they played a role or an impact in a person or in the person's death.
So how did you do this before multidimensional chromatography?
Traditional sample preparation typically utilizes either liquid-liquid extraction or solid phase extraction. It's a time-consuming process, but it's a really effective process of removing the matrix and only isolating the target analytes. But the unfortunate part is that it can be time-consuming, from hours to days, depending on the type of matrix that you're dealing with.
So you said urine is a pretty simple matrix. Can you do this with anything else?
Absolutely. Blood, oral fluid, hair.
And even bone material.
So it looks like the myth has been demystified and that multidimensional chromatography really isn't that hard.
No. After I adopted the technology, we've actually worked together with a number of graduate students from Boston University to actually utilize and optimize methods for multidimensional liquid chromatography.
So let's go to my good old friend the whiteboard and take a look at some data.
Absolutely. In the world of single-dimensional chromatography, we have here a scenario that we can either inject strictly aqueous extract, but in 2D mode, we can inject not only aqueous-based, but also organic-based material. On the bottom chromatogram, you can see we have two metabolites, cocaine and amphetamines. We see that we have a very low signal due to an exchange scenarios on glass vial. But when we convert into an organic extract that comes strictly from a SP material, we have a lot of surprise that in this case over the year, we were surprised to see at least 10x or 2x increase in sensitivity. That's the power of multidimensional chromatography concept.
Wow, that was a blast from the past. And speaking of past, who wouldn't want to use old techniques when you can take advantage of high recovery and a low quantification limit in biological samples by harnessing the power of multidimensional chromatography? For specific details on how this was achieved in matrices such as urine and plasma, check out the link below and join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.